Hi, my name is Francisco Arriaga. I'm a state specialist with the University of Wisconsin Extension Service and the Department of Soil Science. And today I want to talk to you about different devices or things you could use to detect soil compaction. You might have seen a previous video where we showed you how to properly use a penetrometer to detect compaction. So here we want to show you different options if you don't have a $300-$400 penetrometer available for you, where you could use other things to help you assess compaction in the field. The first option is the use of a knife. That would be the simplest way of doing it. And for that, I have a colleague of mine who's going to demonstrate that in the soil pit.
So of course, looking for compaction is much easier when you're actually in a soil pit. And when you look at this pit, you'll notice that we see a lot of platy structure here at the soil surface. We're in a wheel track, so you can see where those wheels have compacted the soil down, and instead of having nice granular structure, that cookie crumb structure, that really small ball type structure that we like to see in a soil profile, instead of seeing that, we see a lot of this platy type structure and very large structure. You'll notice the whole surface wants to act as one solid unit. So we have significant compaction coming down through this profile. You'll notice as we come down through, we get to have a change in texture here at about 9 inches. It starts to get really sandy, and you probably heard that textural change. It wasn't quite as gritty sounding there to something really gritty sounding here. And in a second, Francisco will talk about how he can find that with one of the penetrometers. So at about a 9-inch layer here, we go from what is a nice A horizon that has some compaction. Again, we see instead of granular structure, we see this platy type structure, a very large blocky structure, down into a decently structured E horizon that is very sandy in texture. And we're actually going to be picking that up when we use the penetrometer here in a second. But the one thing I do want you to notice is when we look at the soil profile, even though I'm talking about it being compacted as that soil surface is consolidated, acting as a single layer, notice we still have decent root growth coming down through the soil profile. And as we go through the rest of our video series talking about cover crops and how to improve soil health, this is the kind of root action that we're talking about, helping to reduce some of this unlikely or undesirable physical structure that we see at the soil surface.
So as Jamie just mentioned, you know, very effective to use a knife or another sharp device if you have a soil profile available. Another option would be to use a shovel and dig your own hole to detect compaction through a field. The other point too is, like Jamie pointed out, sometimes you might find denser layers in the soil that they're not necessarily compaction and may not really restrict your root growth of your crops. So another option would be use another sharp device. Here I have a general regular screwdriver, which is about 12 inches long. So you could potentially push this into the field, into the ground, to try to find out if there's compaction. And roughly, you know, we have compaction at about 9 inches in here, or a denser layer, which is caused mainly by that changing texture that Jamie talked about. One key thing I want to mention is that when you're using this type of device, especially the ones that I'm going to show you now, like the screwdriver or this other penetrometer that do not have a gauge, or even these ones with a gauge, you want to find a place that is not compacted to get a background information, kind of correct for that clay content and water content difference that you might have, so you're really getting to the root of the problem with the soil compaction. So this would be an option, using a sharp object like a screwdriver. Here's another penetrometer that UW Extension has been using for the soil health assessment, made by a machine shop locally, which is kind of nice. Has a really nice beefy handle, kind of looks like a tile probe, has the cone following the specifications from the American Society of Biological and Agricultural Engineers, which is a 30 degree cone angle, and with a shoulder. So with this one, you know, be similar to a tile probe or a regular one, so you push it into the ground, and kind of similarly, you know, you have to kind of really develop a feel for it, so you have to practice quite a bit to figure it out, but you know, you can kind of find the compaction depth with this. This one, it's nice enough that it actually has markings in it to help you with the depth detection. So this would be another option. Something like this can run you about $100 or less. You can have a local machine shop build this for you. This is another one that I've shown you before, commercially available, has a nice scale, comes with two different tips, also with the graduations in the rod. This runs about $300-$400. So very useful, but you don't need to go to this level to try to assess compaction in your fields. Something like this with practice can do as good as a job. Now, if we take it to the next level, this is one that I use a lot for research and is available commercially. This one is actually a digital penetrometer that has a digital display. It has a depth sensor built in, and it has a load cell in here. So as you're pushing it into the ground, it actually will tell me with depth every inch the pressure, the PSI, pounds per square inch, and tells me the depth down to 18 inches of depth. If you'd like more information, please contact your local county extension office or the website below.